Shalom, dear friends, and welcome to House of David Ministries. Today, we're going to be talking about Feast of Tabernacles that we just celebrated a couple of weeks ago. And actually, the first two programs, which is today and tomorrow, my wife, Svetlana, she'll be sharing on that subject. But on Wednesday, I'll be here to add to this. So this week is very, very important to listen to and to learn a couple of things that God is speaking to us today. Loud and clear, by the way. So I'm just gonna go and allow you to see that first program where my wife is going to teach on the Feast of Tabernacles. So today and tomorrow, we're gonna have my wife Svetlana sharing, and on Wednesday, I will be teaching you something very, very important from the Bible about the Jewish people. So stay tuned and don't go away. I'll be right back.
Okay. Thank you, Father. Well, today we're celebrating the Feast of Tabernacle, or the Feast of Sukkot. The Feast of Sukkot is one of the three feasts which is conclude the Fall Feast of Israel. The Fall Feast of Israel are very important. It's a time of conclusion of all the biblical feasts. You know that the first Feast of Israel began in April, May, on the first day, on the Hebrew calendar, it's a month of Nisan, which is the Passover. Then the first fruit, the Feast of Unleavened Bread. Then the first fruits. Then we're going to go to Shavuot, the Feast of Harvest in the spring, in the middle of the spring. Then later, it's become the season of a fall feast. It starts with Rosh Hashanah, or Feast of Trumpet, Yom Teruot. Then the Day of Atonement. And now we are right now, Jewish people, celebrating the Feast of Sukkot, which is a conclusion of all the feasts. And you know, this is very important feast, because this is I would say conclude and underline everything what was done by God through the human history. I'm gonna go for you a little bit I'm gonna describe for you interesting thing that you didn't probably know about the feast. But we're gonna go from the beginning, the origin, okay, of the feast is in a book of Leviticus. We're gonna read with you today a lot of scriptures. So I don't know how it's gonna be with translation, but I believe you have to keep up with me. Whoever have French Bibles, whoever have Jewish Bibles or English Bibles, praise the Lord. Maybe some of you have Hebrew Bibles, I don't know. Praise God. So Leviticus 23, it's described the Feast of Sukkot. Now, Leviticus 23, verse 34. Everybody open the Bible? Okay, let's start. Speak to the children of Israel, saying, the 15th day of the seventh month shall be the Feast of Tabernacles for 7 days to the Lord. On the first day there shall be a holy convocation. You shall do no customary work in it. For 7 days you shall offer an offering made by fire to the Lord. On the eighth day you shall have a holy convocation, and you shall offer an offering made by fire to the Lord. It is a sacred assembly, and you shall do no customary work on it. And you shall take for yourself on the first day the fruit of beautiful trees, branches of the palm trees, the leafy trees, the willow of the brook, and you shall rejoice before the Lord your God for 7 days. You shall keep it as a feast for the Lord for 7 days in a year, and it shall be a statute forever in your generation. You shall celebrate in 7 months, and you shall dwell in booth for 7 days. And all who are native Israelites shall dwell in booth, that your generation may know that I made the children